everyone, I'm Sarah, and this is Budgetsew, where we create stylish, fashionable looks as inexpensively as possible. Today, we're doing a sew-along to the Classic Beret from Saturday Night Hat by Eugenia Kim. I've always loved hats, and I've made quite a few on Budgetsew. I've sewed Vogue 7784 out of a luxurious black velvet with gold embroidery. Big brimmed Vogue 8405 out of stiff denim. Butterick 3055 out of some solid and plaid polyester remnants. And the Newsboy from Saturday Night Hats out of some knit houndstooth. I had such fun sewing those hats, I decided to grab my copy of Saturday Night Hat and whip up another hat. Saturday Night Hat is quick and easy hat making for the downtown girl. In this book, Eugenia Kim teaches you to make 30 of her own designs with patterns and instructions so easy you can start the project Saturday afternoon and wear it out Saturday night. I love every single hat that's in this book. I bought it off Amazon.ca for $18.29. It's a secondhand copy, but it's in fantastic condition. I'll post a link to Saturday Night Hats on Amazon.ca in the description box of this video. Eugenia Kim got her inspiration for the Classic Beret from her millinery class. She said, "This beret is always the first hat one learns in millinery class because it's supposed to be one of the easiest styles to make. However, I can't really follow simple how-tos, and 6 sessions into my millinery class, I was still working on the Classic Beret while everyone else had moved on to more difficult chapeau. These uber simple instructions make it easy to master this basic hat in just a few hours. Before we get started, the instructions recommended taking your head measurement. It said, with the tape measure, calculate the head circumference the hat must accommodate. Start with one end of the tape measure at the center of the forehead and bring the tape around to the back of the head to meet the first end of the tape at the center of the forehead. Now that you've got that measurement, let's get started. My first step was to draw a circle for the top of the beret. I used my compass and ruler to measure the radius of the circle to be 5¾ inches. The instruction said, with a compass and pencil, draw a 5¾ inch or 14.6 centimeter radius circle on a piece of paper. This makes the diameter of the hat 11½ inches or 29 centimeters. With the scissors, cut out the circle along your pencil line. This measurement is recommended no matter what your head size. After opening my compass to the largest size possible, I discovered that it wasn't large enough, so I added the compass extension to give a bigger radius. I bought this compass way back in college, and I'm thrilled to still have it. I drew my circle on a scrap piece of pattern paper from a thrifted Berta style pattern that I bought from Value Village. When I cut out the pattern, I thought that this remnant of tissue paper might come in handy. You can see that I haven't used a compass in forever because I moved the center point and had to redraw the circle to make it even. Once that was done, I removed the compass extension to draw another circle inside the original circle. The instruction said, with a compass and pencil, draw a 3⅛ inch or 8 centimeter radius hole at the center of the circle. The diameter of this circle would be 6¼ inches or 16 centimeters. Cut it out. Your template should now look like a donut. If your head circumference is smaller or larger than 22½ inches or 57 centimeters, follow this formula to find the diameter of the inner circle of the template.
take your head measurement divided by 3.14, or pi, minus 1 inch or 2.5 centimeters. Then round up to the nearest quarter inch or 0.6 centimeter. Next, I drew the band of the beret. The instructions said, with the scissors, cut out a 23.5 by 3 inch or 60 by 7.6 centimeter strip of self fabric. This will be the band of the beret. I decided to draw a pattern piece for the band so that if I wanted to make up this beret again, I'd have everything drawn ready to go. When drawing this piece, keep in mind that if you have a larger or smaller head measurement than 22.5 inches or 57 centimeters, then add or subtract 1 inch or 2.5 centimeters to your head measurement for seam allowance, but keep the width at 3 inches or 7.6 centimeters. I enlarged both the inner circle and band templates for my size large head. After I had drawn my pattern pieces, I went over my pencil lines with my blue Sharpie so that all my lines and markings would be permanent. Next, I cut out my pattern pieces. First, I cut out the band and then the donut. I cut around the outer circle and then cut the inner circle. My version of the beret does not include a nub at the top center. The next project in this book shows you how to add it, but this time I stuck with the classic beret. I labeled the donut the classic beret from Saturday Night Hat. When cutting out the pattern pieces from fabric, it should be noted that one donut should be cut out and one full circle without the inner circle. The same for the lining pieces. The band piece should be cut out once of fabric only. No lining piece required. I chose a beautiful green, red, black, and gold plaid for my hat and a red satin for the lining. Here you can see how the pattern should be cut out. One donut of fabric and lining, one full circle of fabric and lining, and one band from fabric only. My next step was to pin the self-fabric donut to the self-fabric circle along the outer edge. The instructions said, pin the two pieces of self-fabric together, right side to right side. Sew along the outside edges with a half an inch or 1.3 centimeter seam allowance. Then I did the same with the red satin lining pieces. For the lining, the instructions recommended half a yard or 0.5 meters of lining fabric in any color and any fabric content. I chose this red satin that I received for free from FabCycle. The link to the video where I received this fabric is at the top of the screen. I had to piece together the lining fabric, but I think it was worth it. The red satin complements the plaid perfectly. Then I folded the headband piece in half and pinned it along the short edge. This will be sewn with a half an inch or 1.3 centimeter seam allowance. I bought the plaid fabric from a Fabricland store closing sale in Stratford, Ontario. At the sewing machine, I sewed the self-fabric circle and donut together first. The fabric was originally $26 a meter, but they had it on clearance for $6.50 a meter. And since the store was closing, I received an additional 50% off. There were only 1.2 meters left on the bolt, but I really liked the plaid and I was sure that I could make something out of it. Since I had 1.2 meters of fabric, I decided to make a matching bag. I chose Simplicity 9553 View 2 from 1971. The link to the video with the sew along to Simplicity 9553 is at the top of the screen. Next, I sewed the satin lining circle and donut together. This fabric was pieced together because it was a remnant from FabCycle. Scraps are free from FabCycle, but you have to pay shipping or pick up the scraps from their Vancouver-based reuse center. The scraps come in various sizes. Some are as small as 2 centimeters and some are much larger and could come in uneven cuts. I don't mind piecing together fabric, so these were great for me. Since I ordered $100 worth of fabric on my order from FabCycle, I requested one medium box of scraps, which was about 3 kilograms. Next, I sewed the beret band together along the short edge with a 1/2 inch or 1.3 centimeter seam allowance. To make a cleaner curve line, I clipped 3/8 of an inch or 1 centimeter long slits around the seam allowance at 1/4 inch or 0.6 centimeter intervals all the way around the beret and lining. When I laid out the pattern pieces onto fabric for the classic beret and the simplicity bag, I realized that there was just enough fabric left over to make one more item. I chose the patchwork scarf from Lotta Yon's daughter's book, Everyday Style. My mom bought a copy of Everyday Style online from Book Outlet and recommended this project because it's a great scrap buster. Then I turned the beret right side out and pressed the seam flat with my Panasonic Freestyle iron. I absolutely love my iron, and if you would like to know how wonderful I think it is, then check out my Freestyle Steam Iron review video. The link is at the top of the screen. Then I placed the lining shell inside the self shell so that the seam allowance was hidden from the outside. Then I pinned it in place because the satin was so slippery. I've really enjoyed reading Saturday Night Hat by Eugenia Kim. The step-by-step instructions are so simple and clear that it makes sewing hats a breeze. I love all the hat designs, trims, and millinery lingo in the book. There's even a handy glossary at the back of the book to clarify everything. Then I pinned the raw edge of the head size band to the inside circle or the donut hole. If you can't decide on a fabric for your beret, Eugenia Kim suggested cutting up the plaid skirt from your 5th grade school uniform. She also recommended that if you chose a solid color for your beret, then choose a fun, flirty fabric for the lining just to spice up the design with a little surprise. She said, "Hats with a cute lining are like racy lingerie worn underneath a black or navy business suit." At the sewing machine, I sewed the band to the crown with a 1/2 inch or 1.3 centimeter seam allowance. I used black Coates & Clark all-purpose dual duty thread that I bought from Value Village Thrift Store. I don't use secondhand thread when sewing my garments, but this thread was in a big bag of brand new Coates & Clark thread for $1.99. There were about 20 spools of black and white thread in the bag, so it was quite a steal. I checked the thread before buying it, and it was very strong, and it was actually newer than some of the thread in my sewing box. This step is not in the instructions, but I wanted all the raw edges finished. I used double fold extra wide bias tape to finish the headband seam. I didn't want any frayed edges ending up in my hair if I took off my beret. I used some Belding brand bright red bias tape that my mom bought years ago for Christmas placemats. It was an economy pack that could trim four placemats that measured 33 by 48 centimeters. It was 65% polyester and 35% cotton, and my mom got it on sale. At the sewing machine, I sewed the bias tape to the beret. This is my domestic sewing machine's first appearance on Budgetsew. Brad bought me this machine off Facebook Marketplace for $40 as a surprise present for me. He knew that I loved old metal sewing machines because they're built like tanks. They can sew through anything. The seller on Facebook Marketplace promised him that it worked, so we bought it. He tested it at our home and the light turned on and the needle went up and down. After I oiled the machine, I found that the stitch length was stuck on the tiniest stitch possible. The stitch length gears inside the machine had become jammed over time. I googled how to fix this and I watched so many YouTube videos, but nothing worked. I oiled the machine a second time and worked all the gears again. After the second oiling, the stitch length just popped back into place. I was thrilled. This machine doesn't look like it's been used very much, and it came with the original felt pads that slipped over the spool holders. Saturday Night Hat also has some millinery TLC for caring for your hat. Dirty cut and sew hats should be taken to the dry cleaners, especially if the hats are made from buckram. You can hand wash hats without buckram or the silk scarf you made yourself for the sun hat. However, it's important to let all your cut and sew hats dry in their own time. Drying your chapeau in the dryer could shrink them, wrinkle the fabric near the seams, or fade the brilliant colors over time. Your hat will give back to you what you give it, so take good care of your special chapeau. Here is the finished beret.
The look, I'm wearing a Hagar sweater that I bought at Sears Outlet Store. The Calvin Klein dress pants are from the Hudson's Bay Company, and the shoes are from Payless. The necklace came from Value Village thrift stores, and the bag is Simplicity 9553. I posted the link to the sew along to Simplicity 9553 in the description box of this video. I hope you enjoyed my sew along to the Classic Beret from Saturday Night Hat. Please like and share this video with your friends and family. I love sharing my new, vintage, and out-of-print sewing patterns, and my tips, tricks, quick fixes, and even my mistakes when sewing along with you. I also love sharing my wonderful fabric finds that I thrifted from charity shops, as well as brand new fabric online and in-store. If you'd like to see more from Budgetsew, please subscribe and press the bell to receive a notification when I release a new video. If you'd like to stay up to date with Budgetsew, follow me on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook at Budgetsew. Thanks for watching. See you next time.